Tesla battery supplier will begin production of a new condensed battery. Friends, major battery supplier of Tesla, CATL, has launched a new battery it says is energy dense enough to work use in passenger aircraft. The battery set to go into mass production later this year has an energy density of 500 Wh kilogram. To be honest, I don't know what Wh kilogram is. I used to know, but I forgot. Anyway, so it's a lot to be able to work in a passenger aircraft. Now, CATL, which is a major Tesla battery supplier, will be one of the first companies to mass produce a battery with an energy density of 500 Wh kilogram or more. A US-based company, Argonne, announced its new battery technology will feature 1,200 Wh kilogram, but is not ready for mass production yet, whereas CATL's is already ready for mass production. For reference, Tesla's new 4680 battery cells, actually those cell batteries, have an energy density rating of 272 to 296 Wh kilogram, which is considered very high. Imagine how big is CATL's new battery. CATL is cooperating with partners in development of electric passenger aircraft. I mean, let me repeat that again. CATL is cooperating with partners in development of electric passenger aircraft and practicing aviation level standards and testing in accordance with aviation grade safety and quality requirements, said the brand. Do you think Tesla may one day decide to build electric passenger aircrafts? I don't know. What do you think? Let me know, friends, in the comment section below. The company is referring to it as its condensed battery and says it has technology that can improve the performance of cells and offer excellent charge and discharge performance. I mean, imagine if Tesla can use this battery in its vehicle, unless Tesla wants to really be a partner in building electric passenger planes or something like that. Anyway, its lightweight profile and new battery technology will open up a new wave of electrification possibilities, which center around a high level of safety, says the company. CATL, a Chinese company, has confirmed that an automotive version of this battery technology is currently under development and will begin to production later this year. So later this year, Tesla may have new batteries, much denser, bigger range. Remember my word, expect in 2024 to hear about bigger, longer ranges for Tesla and electric vehicles. It appears CATL may have plans to tackle more than just the aviation and automotive industries, with the company saying the launch of condensed batteries will usher in an era of universal electrification of sea, land, and air transportation. The Chinese battery manufacturer is responsible for supplying batteries to automakers like Tesla and Geely. Recently, CATL announced it's working with Chinese vehicle manufacturer Chery to launch its first sodium-ion battery, which will feature in the car maker's future lineup. Very exciting news. What do you think about this, friends? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. This is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. So, Tesla battery supplier has reached for the sky with this new technology, meaning they want to build batteries for electric planes. I don't know whether they're passenger planes or what type of planes, but they are also working with an automotive version of the battery, and CATL has confirmed it'll begin mass production this year of its new condensed battery with an energy density of 500 Wh per kilogram. Does that mean 500 watt per kilogram or something else? If you guys know what Wh per kilogram is, let me know please in the comment section below. After I upload this video, I will also check it out. God bless you and have a great day. See you soon in our next report. We now know the battery capacity of the new Tesla Model Y that is being produced in Germany at Giga Berlin using the BYD battery, and also it has a midnight cherry red color. Friends, everyone is talking about in the automotive industry and Tesla enthusiast industry about the new midnight cherry red color Tesla that Tesla is Tesla Model Y that Tesla is building at Giga Factory Berlin, and it's using the BYD battery. Several days ago, I reported reported about that, and based on the German publication, which uses the word small Tesla Model Y, meaning a lower range. Apparently in German language there is similarities between those words, and people were wondering how lower is range of this new Model Y that Tesla Giga Berlin is building. In this report, I'm going to tell you how lower that range is, how different is the new Model Y with BYD battery compared to the Model Y that Tesla is usually building with CATL battery, and you're going to know all about that. So, Tesla Gigafactory in Berlin has started production of new Model Y versions, both in terms of battery supplier and when it comes to the color, to the electric SUV, which is now available. The world's second biggest battery maker and main Tesla competitor, BYD, has been rumored to become its fourth battery supplier since last summer. Those rumors were recently confirmed as the first Model Y batches with BYD's structural LFP battery pack have appeared on the conveyor belts at Tesla Giga Berlin factory. At the time, the regulatory database that had the new Model Y with the BYD battery locked for a good while still pegged it as having a 55 kilowatt our capacity. For comparison, the current Chinese version of the CATL LFP battery cells is 60 kilowatt hour, but a recent buyer, however, revealed in the local Tesla forum that the VIN number checks were misleading. According to their Tesla advisor, the new Model Y built at Gigafactory Berlin with BYD battery turned out to be 59 kilowatt hour. Consider CATL battery that Tesla has been using is 60 kilowatt hour. The BYD battery is not much less. It's only 59 kilowatt hour, only 1 kilowatt hour less. The range should therefore be the same as the version with CATL battery, but 455 kilometer on the WLTP cycle, provided that the Model Y with BYD cells is on 19-inch wheels. The Berlin-made standard range Model Y, however, would have other advantages with BYD battery if its structural pack is made of BYD blade batteries. The LFP cells can be easily charged to the maximum all the time with no significant degradation and are much safer. Now, according to BYD, while undergoing nail penetration tests, the blade battery emitted neither smoke nor fire after being penetrated, and its surface temperature only reached 30 to 60 degrees Celsius. The blade battery pack has also been subjected to other extreme test conditions, such as being crushed, bent, being heated in a furnace to 300 degrees Celsius, and overcharging by 260%. None of these resulted in a fire or explosion, adds the world's second largest battery maker, BYD. Besides the new standard range Model Y with BYD LFP battery, the Gigafactory Berlin, which boasts Tesla's most advanced paint shop, has started churning out the long-awaited Midnight Cherry Red color. The first Model Y batch in Midnight Cherry Red can be previewed online in different videos, and it's going to be really exciting to see new beautiful cherry color, midnight cherry red color. So, but the bigger news is that the battery that Tesla is using, many people were worried that it will be lower range, smaller, but no, it still gives you 455 kilometers, to be honest, off the top of my head. I don't know how to turn it to miles, what, maybe 350, 370, I don't know. Someone can maybe do the math and also post in the comment section below. But it's a 59 kilowatt hour versus CATL LFP batteries 60 kilowatt hours. This is the main news, because some people were expecting it to be 55, but it's 59, 4 kilowatt hour more from expectation, and just only 1 kilowatt hour less from CATL LFP battery, which is Tesla's main battery supplier. So let me know your thoughts. What do you think about this new Tesla? Especially, looks like it has a lot of, this battery has a lot of advantages that BYD has stated.